think a lot of people end up getting in trouble in avalanche accidents because we're making emotional decisions in an environment where being wrong, you don't often get to learn from your mistakes.
There's something about the mountains and the scale that I think just draws emotion out of people. And we want to protect the positive feelings of the backcountry. We want to preserve some of those important emotions. We've had friends partially buried in avalanches, lost friends in avalanches. This is something that we care deeply about. So at AvaTech, we believe that saving lives starts with understanding the snow under our feet and avoiding avalanches before they happen. We're developing a new proactive avalanche safety technology that can help people understand the snow quickly, accurately, and objectively, and then share that information more broadly with the mountain community.
AvaTech is a very unique combination of incredible backgrounds, of varied experiences and technologies that I've never seen in the outdoor space. And when we think of avalanche safety today, it's really talking about triage, all different ways of, after you get caught in an avalanche, what we're trying to do is look ahead of that and go, how do you avoid an avalanche? How do you completely stay away from them?
The SP1 is really exciting. It's our first product that we're launching as a company. It's the hardware part of the entire bigger system. And this idea of making this technology accessible to people, that's really what we're going for.
The snowpack is really complex, and we want the SP1 to make it much easier for the people out there in the backcountry to assess how the snow changes in space and time.
The physical characteristics of the snowpack, the thermal parameters, the mechanical parameters, they depend greatly on the crystalline structure, which is really hard to detect through the normal ways that we would look at snow. AvaTech, I think, has the capability of helping us collect information to improve the products that we're putting out there.
I can't dig 20 holes in a day, but I could certainly take 20 probe profiles. So if I have that knowledge and I want to track a weak layer throughout different elevations, across different aspects or over time, I can use the SP1 to basically confirm presence and absence of these particular weak layers, which gives me a much better handle on how widespread a particular avalanche problem may be.
We're monitoring our snowpack constantly. To be able to just ski and sample that was a huge breakthrough for us. What would have taken me a week to do, I could sample the same amount of terrain in a day. So with the AvaTech probe, you're not just getting depth, you're getting the stratigraphy as well. It's not my opinion of the snow. This is how many kilopascals it took to drive that tip through those grains. That's of tremendous value.
Conditions change fast and there's spatial variability. And so to have a tool that works quickly and gathers that information, and then even better, it can be shared really easily. I think it's really going to revolutionize how we can look at snowpack.
What's so cool about the SP1 is that it's not only useful on the mountain, but it syncs to your smartphone, it syncs to the web, it gives anyone anywhere the ability to see what you're doing and what's going on the mountain in real time.
If this product becomes widely used, is crowdsourcing of stratigraphy and snowpack information, where a whole crew of people are using the same device with the same output being collected from all around the world. And that's a very exciting prospect to understand avalanche formation and therefore also be able to drive avalanche forecasting if we have a better understanding about structure across multiple spatial scales.
I think we're at the dawn of something really great here. This product is something that I know we're going to look back on 20 years from now, 40 years from now, and know that we had a really positive impact on the sport.
When you get a call and someone says a product that you helped in some remote way work on helped save someone's life, you can come home after a day and go, yeah, it was a pretty good day.
Mm.
We are bringing a new and exciting technology to market here. By helping people make better decisions, we know that we're doing our part to help make the entire mountain community much safer.